from our spirit. It comes from our soul, our intellect, and our emotions, and our will. In other words, he says, as we grow, as we get closer to God, as we mature in God, then what happens is that we prosper according to his will and according to his purpose. That's why you must understand that your success in life is directly connected to your spirit and to your emotion and to your intellect and to your will, which is called the soul. That's the soulish part of your spirit. So that means if I'm going to be successful like God wants me to be successful, then I have to examine my spirit. I have to examine my emotions. I have to examine my mind. I have to examine my intellect, what I put into me, what I learn about God. I have to examine that, because that determines what level of success I'm going to live in this life. Now, what I want to do is put it in this rightful place, because when you look at the book of Joshua, amen, God gives Joshua a divine fulfillment of covenant. He calls it good success. In other words, he said to Joshua, he says, I want you to let my people know that if they will listen to my word and obey my word and don't let it depart out of their mouth, but walk by, observe it, and as it is written, he says, they shall be prosperous and they shall have good success. Then that let me know the fact that, amen, we can be prosperous in life, but are we having good success? That also prompts the challenge to us is that we can have success, but not good success in life. Success simply means to gain accomplishments or aims or goals, to obtain popularity and profit. So that means that I can set my success for myself to attain some goals and some aims so that I gain popularity and I get some profit. But does that, amen, merit God giving any of the glory out of what I do if I just be successful? So God says to Joshua that I want to move you from just being successful, but I want you to go and walk in good success. Everybody say, I need my good success. Success, I found, Elder, is not enough for me to live by now. I desire God's good success. Are you hearing me up in here? And so when, amen, when God, amen, speaks to Joshua and tells him that I'm going to give you, I'm going to open the door that you walk in good success, what separates the word from success is good. And the word good, amen, when it's added to success, means God ordained best. So God wants me to have his ordained best. Good means God's supernatural favor. Good means God's fulfillment in his will. Good means not only that I get benefits as I live according to how God wants me to live, and these benefits will be extraordinary. They will be spontaneous. They will be unspeakable. They will be undeniable. They will be kingdoms extra. When I come to understand that I want to not just live by the success of my own accomplishments, I want to live by God's good success that he gives me and allow me to walk in the extraordinary. He allowed me to walk in his spontaneous way of opening up favor for me. He desired for me to walk in those unspeakable things where people say, I don't know how they got that. I don't know how they got there. Amen. He wants me to walk in his undeniable kingdom extra. There's some stuff God has for us that is extra. Amen. God said, I have them there for you, and I'm just waiting for you to find out how to obtain a good success in life. So many times we try to get successful, Pastor, based on all of our own accomplishment. There's nothing wrong with you trying to excel in life and trying to accomplish things, amen, by your own abilities. But you must understand, when you walk into God, there's something that you don't realize that's been waiting on you. The psalmist declared, the Lord is a sun and a shield. The Lord giveth grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from them that walk upright. That's why I try to live right, because that lets me know no good thing will he withhold from me if I do what he wants me to do according to his will. You see, what people don't understand, sometimes your life is hard because you're walking in a place of transgression. The Bible said the way